second grade. It's so good to see you. Welcome back after a week off from our music classes, but we are back and ready for another exciting digital music class with Mr. Houchin. Let's see what's on tap for today. So, take a look. We've got our hello song, which we just sang. Do a little warm on up again. More Mi, Re, and Do. With Alison's Camel. Who's that? A new song, Mr. Rabbit. We'll spend some time with our musician of the month, and then we'll sing goodbye. Now, my goals for you for today. I've got three goals. Our first goal is to sing some patterns with Mi, Re, and Do, not only by themselves, but find them in our songs. And we're going to find more Mi, Re's, and Do's in Alison's Camel today. With Who's That, we're going to do our second goal, which is to add a B section to a song, which means a second part. And then with our Mr. Rabbit, we're just going to begin learning that new song so we can do more fun things with it next time. But right now, let's come back to me so that we can do some warming up. Last week, I taught you a fun one where we kind of shake out our bodies. And so if you want to, this one's really fun if you stand up. So go ahead and stand up and get some room so you can shake your hands and your feet. And we're going to start with shaking our hands four times each and then our feet. And then we shake them three times, two times, one time, until we're shaking our whole body at the same time. So pick your favorite hand, and let's shake it together four times and go. Ready? One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Shake your foot. Two, three, four. Other foot. Two, three. Now three times. One, two, three. One, two, three. Foot, two, three. Foot, two. Now and one, two. One, two. One, two, one, now one, 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 and shake your whole body out. Shake your face out like this, ready? And now shake your lips out like this. Try that again. Make your voice go nice and high. And how about a nice yawn off of the highest part of our voice like this? Can you go even higher? Let's try it. Waking up our voice, our body, our neighbors when we do things like that. All right, all right. Feeling good. I have a new little warm-up I'd like you to do. It all involves singing the same pitch, but we're going to sing lots of different sounds on it. So we're going to sing Mi, Me, Ma, Mo, Mu. We're going to sing all of our vowel sounds. Mi, Me, Ma, Mo, Mu. Sing that with me again, ready? Mi, Me, Ma, Mo, Mu. Mi, Me, Ma, Mo, Mu. Mi, Me, Ma, Mo, Mu. Now we've been putting the letter M in front of those sounds. What if we change it to a V sound, a V sound? Vi, Ve, Va, Vo, Vu. Vi, Ve, Va, Vo, Vu. What about a T sound? Ti, Te, Ta, To, Tu. Or a Z sound? Zi, Ze, Za, Zo, Zu. Or an F sound? Fi, Fe, Fa, Fo, Fu. Nice job, nice job. And let's end our warm-up with a little breathing. Breathing in slowly through our nose and slowly out of our mouth like this. Breathe in. And out. Let's try that a little slower. In slower through your nose. Ready? In. And out. And let's do one more where we're going in and out as long, as slow, and as peacefully as we can. Ready? Breathe in. And out. Deep breath and sigh. And just let all your worries go away. All right, well, let's keep on going with some of our Mi, Re, and Do. Let's just do a little repeating after me. Do, 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 do. Do, 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 re, do, 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 re, do, do, re, 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 do, do, re, 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 do, do, re, re, mi, mi, do, re, re, mi, 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 re, do, mi, re, mi, re, do, do, mi, re, re, mi, do, mi, re, re, mi, do, mi, re, re, do, do, mi, re, re, do, 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 mi, do, 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 mi, do, re, 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 mi, do, re, 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 mi, do, 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 mi, do, 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 mi, do, mi, re, do, mi, re, do. Nice work, nice work. Remember, do right now is our lowest pitch. Re is sort of in the middle, and it points up to our highest pitch, mi, when we're talking about do, re, and mi. Now, of course, we have a couple of other high pitches. We have so and la, but for right now, we're going to focus on do, re, and mi with our next couple of songs. Which reminds me of a song we've been doing for a couple of classes now, called Alison's Camel. Let me hear you sing along, nice, loud, and proud. Alison's camel has five humps. Alison's camel has five humps. Alison's camel has five humps. So go, Alison, go, bum, bum, bum. Alison's camel has four humps. Alison's camel has four humps. Alison's camel has four humps. So go, Alison, go. Now wait, 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 wait. Last week, we found out that there was some me's, re's, and do's in Alison's camel. And let's take a look at our board. This is what they looked like. So we've got three lines across the staff. We've got the word go on the middle line. Then we've got the word Alison on the very first space, and then below that we have the word go on the bottom line. And you might remember last week we could sing, go Alison, go. Or if we use mi, re, and do, we could sing, mi, re, re, do. Now when I sang the re's, I went, re, re, re. I sang three re's. Why did I do that? Oh yeah, I remember, because the rhythm to the word Alison has three sounds, so I put three rays for the word Alison. So we've got mi, re, 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 do. So how about I sing Alison's camel has three Alison's camel has three humps, and you can, instead of singing go, Alison, go, you could sing mi, re, 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 do. Alison's camel has three humps. Alison's camel has three humps. Alison's camel has three humps. So mi, re, 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 do. Alison's camel has two humps. Alison's camel has two humps. Alison's camel has two humps. So mi, re, 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 do. And Alison's camel has one hump. Alison's camel has one hump. Alison's camel has one hump. So mi, re, 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 do. And Alison's camel, she's got no humps. Alison's camel's got no humps. Alison's camel has no humps. So Alison has a horse, of course. I always like ending a song with a joke. Now, there's some more mi's, re's, and do's in this song, and I'm going to help you find them. So whenever we sing one hump, or two humps, or three humps, or four humps, or five humps, or even no humps, that it sounds the same every time we sing it. And it sort of sounds a little high, and then a little low, and we have to do a little bit of a jump there with our voice. So if we're just dealing with do, re, and mi, and we're going from the high pitch to the lowest pitch, then that means that instead of singing one hump, we can sing mi, do. So I want you to try it this time like this. See if you can spot what I do. Alison's camel has Bido. Alison's camel has Bido. Alison's camel has Bido. So me, ray, 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 do. Can you try adding in some more Mido's to our song? You got it. All right. That's it for Allison's Camel today. Maybe next time we can put all the mi, re's, and do's in and sing the whole song using our hand signs and our pitches. But for now, let's jump over to another song we worked on last time. It goes a little something like this. Let's do it in a... And it goes like this. Keep the beat with me. Who's that tapping on my window? Who's that knocking on my door? Who's that tapping on my window? Who's that knocking on my door? Who's that tapping on my window? Who's that knocking on my door? Who's that tapping on my window? Who's that knocking on my door? Let's try doing a little singing, shall we? Repeat after me. My turn first. Who's that? Who's that tapping on my window? Tapping on my window. Who's that? Who's that knocking at my door? Knocking at my door. Do the whole song already, here we sing. Who's that tapping at my window? Who's that knocking at my door? Who's that tapping at my window? Who's that knocking at my door?
What if we sang that song without our singing voices and just use our bodies to make the sounds? So we pat our legs, we tap our window, pat our legs again, and knock at the door. Let's try it. Take your voices. Put them away. One and two. Just your bodies this time. Nice work. Now I want to add a new part to this song, a whole new section that we're going to do after we sing that song. In music, we sometimes call that a B section. It's sort of the second section of the song. The first section would probably then be called the A section, because A comes first in the alphabet. So A is who's that tapping on my window, and here's our new B section. It's actually a joke. I'm going to keep the beat, and it goes like this. Knock, knock. Who's there? Banana. Banana who? Knock, knock. Who's there? Banana. Banana who? Knock, knock. Who's there? Orange. Orange who? Orange you. And I didn't say banana again. Now, it's a little hard to do a joke all by yourself. So you have to imagine that it's two people sort of talking back and forth. Maybe I can do it like this. So, knock, knock. Who's there? Banana. Banana who? Knock, knock. Who's there? Banana. Banana who? Knock, knock. Who's there? Orange. Orange who? Orange you. Glad I didn't say banana again. Ha! So let's try it. How about you be the answer to my knock, knock joke, and I'll say the joke. So I say, knock, knock, and you say, who's there? So, knock, knock. Who's there? Banana. And you say, banana who? Knock, knock. Who's there? Banana. Banana who? Knock, knock. Who's there? Orange. Orange who? Orange you. Glad I didn't say banana again. Who's that tapping at my window? Who's that knocking at my door? Who's that tapping at my window? Who's that knocking at my door?
So here's what we'll do next time.
We'll put that song all together with our A section, our B section, and then we'll sort of put them in different orders and create a whole new version of the song. In the meantime, can you practice that joke for me? It's really funny, and the more you tell it to somebody, the funnier it is. So just try telling it to somebody over and over again, and I'm sure they'll start laughing. I'm sure they won't find that annoying at all. All right. Well, enough of that song for now. I want to introduce you one final new song today before we move on to our musician of the month. And really, this is our first listen. This is our first chance to hear it. So I'm not asking for too much. Just listen, enjoy, and I'll have you sing along and do a little repeat after me. But this song is called Hey, Mr. Rabbit. Hey, Mr. Rabbit, what do you say? Hey, Mr. Rabbit, I'm ready to play. Hey, Mr. Rabbit, here's my plea. Hey, Mr. Rabbit, please choose me. Pretty simple. Now, can you repeat after me? I'm going to sing some patterns, some sounds. They're really simple. Just repeat after me. Take that song, put it in your brain for next time. We'll play around with it a little bit more. All right. So let's now hop over to our musician of the month and learn a little bit more about the roots. So what I want to share with you today is about two of the main members of the Roots. So the Roots is this big band, but it sort of started with these two fellows over here. Now, the first one, his name is Questlove, and that's sort of what we call a stage name. His real name is Amir Thompson, but he's been going by Questlove for a long time, and he is the drummer of the group. And the other gentleman up here is a man by the name of Black Thought, and again, that's also a stage name for him. His real name is Tariq Trotter, and these two fellas met when they were back in high school, when they were students in high school, and they would go outside after school, they would go out to the street corner, and Questlove would bring a bucket and some drumsticks and start to drum, and Black Thought would rap over Questlove while he was playing on the drums. And that's sort of how the band started. Eventually they met more musicians and more people and created the group we know as The Roots. And so I want to feature both these musicians today. I've got a video of Questlove, and I'll share another video with Black Thought in the description of this video. So let's start with Questlove. He's a drummer, plays a lot of drum set, and here is a video of him performing alongside of one of Sesame Street's finest, Grover. So this is Questlove on Sesame.
Hello there. M is for musician. A musician is a person who plays an instrument, like the drums here. To help me show you what a musician does, I have with me here my good friend, Mr. Questlove.
Hi.
A drummer is a musician. And luckily, we have one of the world's most amazing drummers right here.
Oh, man. Thank you, Grover.
Me!
You?
Correct. Now, are you ready to try and do what I do?
Sure.
That is the spirit. Okay, now, watch carefully. I call this the da-dum.
The da-dum.
Yes, here it comes.
Okay.
Okay. Did you get that? It is okay if you need me to do it again.
Hey, I think I got it. Yeah? Okay, this is the da-dum.
Yes.
Okay.
Well, wow, you are a very quick learner, Mr. Questlove.
Yeah.
Are you ready for something really hard, though? I call this the deedle-deedle-dum. Hang on to your hi-hat, because here it comes. It is perfectly okay if you want to give up now.
No.
No shame. Not from this direction.
I think I got it.
Okay. Yeah?
The deedle-deedle-dum.
Yes.
Okay.
Wow! You are one promising student!
Hey, thanks, Grover. Hey, Grover.
Hmm?
Can I try something for you?
Well, if you want, I do not want you to embarrass yourself.
Oh.
But okay. Do not be afraid. Just try something.
Okay, this is called something. Here we go.
That certainly was something. So, that's our friend Questlove. He's one part of the founding of the Roots. In the description of this video, I have a link to a video featuring Black Thought. And this video is of Black Thought performing a song from the musical Hamilton. Some of you might know Hamilton as a Broadway musical that sort of takes a look at American history, but using hip-hop and rap music. And Black Thought took the song My Shot from Hamilton and sort of created his own version of it. The link to that video is in the description of this video if you want to check it out. Hope you've enjoyed the Roots for our month of April, and I hope they've been a great musician of the month for you. And keep on listening, and we'll find out who our musician of the month for next month is next week. All right. So we are at the end of another music class, so it's time to sing goodbye, but not for long. I'll see you guys next Tuesday for another second grade digital music class. Goodbye, second grade. Goodbye, second grade. Goodbye, second grade. And thank you for music today. Goodbye, second grade.